with a very excited Maria, who's showing us how to salvage our outdated vases with a faux matte ceramic finish. And you should be excited, by the way, because these are pretty fantastic.
Listen, I don't like to play favorites with my DIYs, but this is definitely one of the favorites. I will tell you, so right now, as you know, we recently moved, and I was able to decorate my house, and I wanted to have this cohesive look throughout the house, and I love terracottas and corals and peaches. Mm. And this matte finish on these ceramics is so popular right now, but they can be so expensive. You know, that like that pottery type of feel,
like
the terracotta.
Course, yeah.
So you can create that in your own home by basically taking any leftover things you have around your house that maybe aren't fitting, like I have here, and with this technique, they can turn out just like that.
It's pretty genius, I gotta say. And you might be wondering at home, like, do our family members kind of walk the walk? These are from Maria's house. Like, this is what she does. She's done this and she's showing us how to do it too. So let's get started.
That's true. I was like, my husband's like, where are you taking our like stuff?
Like, just in case you think this is fabricated, this is the real deal. Okay, so what do we got here? I know we need some acrylic water-based paint.
Yeah, so it's a water-based paint is what you're looking for as your base. So Cameron, you can see there, you have a little mixture.
Yeah.
What I love to do with paints is to really get creative and make my own colors. So don't be limited to what you see in the store. Mix and match just as long as it's water-based.
Okay.
So what makes it that matte finish, sort of that chalky finish?
Sure.
That makes it so like pottery looking, ceramic looking, is baking powder. And so I'm gonna start adding it in and I'm gonna tell you why. So
I mix mine, so I start adding this in here too?
Yeah, you can start adding it in.
Okay.
So roughly, I mean, I found, this is the thing, I couldn't get you a perfect measurement for this because all paints are a little bit different. Okay. I would say for about a cup, I would add in a couple tablespoons.
Okay.
But like I said, I just add a little bit at a time and I mix until it starts to kind of be the texture that I want it to be.
Really cool stuff. And by the way, it comes alive when you do this.
It comes alive. It's
like
so
it's
exciting.
Like bubbles and stuff.
So all the bakers watching out there, I know you're wondering, why baking powder? Can I use my baking soda? So the reason the baking powder works for this, so when you're baking, right? You have two leavenings you generally use. You have baking soda, you have baking powder, right? So the baking soda is sodium bicarbonate. The baking powder is sodium bicarbonate with an acid in it. So if that makes sense. So a lot of times if you're using baking soda, you're putting it with things
you
that are like...
You add one that already has the acid and you add the other one that doesn't have the acid.
Exactly.
Right?
So the baking soda that doesn't have the acid is good for things with like buttermilk, sour cream, all of those things. Whereas the baking powder is sort of its own entity. It doesn't need as much acidity to react.
Which is why we're using the baking powder.
That is why we're doing that today. That's the big story for why we're using baking powder. And as you can see, it's already bubbling up.
It comes up.
Like you can see here.
And I don't know if you guys can tell at home, but there really is like a lot of texture on these, okay? So this is where you're getting. It's really super tangible. Like it's very gritty and wonderful. Okay.
Yes.
Very good. So we got the science behind it. And now, basically, how do you know when it's all mixed in? You mix it until there's
clumps,
right?
And look at this. Look, you can see.
I've lost Maria.
Look at that. That is what you're looking for, that reaction.
Oh, I need more then.
Oh, yeah, you need to add more. And so another great thing about this, too, is you can see I'm using glass. A lot of times when you paint on glass, it becomes streaky. You have to do all these coats. But if you see here, when I take this thick mixture here, look at that. Look at how it coats it so nicely. I know. And then as it dries, it's going to have that chalky finish on there. So I'm going to do a little bit more on here, as you can see.
Amazing.
But I want to give you an idea of different surfaces to put this on. So I'm going to swap and actually look at this one puffing up. Oh my gosh, it's so exciting. When it actually works, it's like so satisfying. And we use a little bit of this. So you can see here, these are the different, and you want it to be thick and you can layer it on. And the baking powder will dissolve and leave that texture and that chalkiness and everything on there as well.
You know, that look, we've been talking about this, it's sort of like a good earthy, rustic, modern feel to this, right? It's very in too, by the way.
Yes.
Okay, beautiful. All right, so now as we're doing this, we gotta let, how long, I mean, basically it takes as long to dry as a normal water-based paint. So once it's dry, you have some options to kind of add a little bit of a design element to a little gold edge.
Yeah, right? I like to make my things fancy sometimes. So,
check this out.
Oh,
I mean, it's like a science class over here.
Oh my gosh, I love it. So to add a little bit of the gold on there, I'm using like a gold foil paint.
Whoa.
You can see right here, a gold leaf paint. And all you do is add the details on there. This is very strong paint. You do not need much of it. And just add this as much as you like. And that's really it, that you don't have to do this, but I think if you want to make it extra fancy, you can, and that's what makes it really pretty.
I gotta say, Maria, I am getting lost in this. No wonder you love this so much.
I love it.
Really well done, guys. You gotta try this, everybody. Full instructions. Head over to HallmarkChannel.com. They'll all be there, although this is pretty easy, and you may have gotten everything right now.